Okay, welcome everyone to Puppies Heaven's designer Puppies Explained video. Let's grab this little guy over here so he's not gonna, make too much noise. So we're here at Puppy Heaven in our beautiful location in Agora Hills. This is our beautiful store. We have, adorable teacup and toy puppies that are up for adoption. They're all looking for, good families to take them home and love them forever. Today we're going to talk a little bit about designer breeds, which are basically a cross of two purebred dogs that, produce beautiful and a lot of, advantages to the small breed, and we're going to talk a little bit about that today. This is our first live video. We've never done it before, but we thought, it's going to give some, it's going to shed some light on, what are designer breeds, and what are the benefits of having a designer breed versus a purebred dog. So we have here today three of our beautiful, designer breed puppies. There are three different mixes. So this guy is
Moshi, Maltese, and Shih Tzu. Simba.
This guy's little Simba, which is a beautiful Maltese puppy. That's what we call them. There's, a couple other names that people, call them these days. Some people call them like teddy bears, and because they do look like, very sweet teddy bears. And we call them Maltese, which basically stands for a Maltese and Shih Tzu mixed together. Both breeds are very good, they make very good family pet, Malteses are, of course, hypoallergenic, so is the Shih Tzus. So altogether we get a puppy that's hypoallergenic. Hypoallergenic dog means, that they do not shed hair like short hair breeds. So their hair basically, grows long, and it's like human hair altogether. This little guy is approximately 9.5 weeks old, so he's still in his baby stage, and we can see he's very sweet. He's gonna a little bit yapping around, looking for someone to play with. We try to put a little mini-me with him, which is our, tiny Morkie puppy that we have here. But they don't seem like they're getting along to each one just, want our attention. That's a nice thing about, those little puppies. They love attention, and that's why they are very affectionate. They're very loving. That's another big benefit of having, a cute small dog in general, but the smaller ones, in particular, because you see, you can't do that with a big, golden retriever or a boxer. You can't just kind of cut it and do it and get, so. That's a big advantage of having a smaller dog. If we stay with Simba here, so Simba is very small right now. Right now he weighs, approximately 2.5, almost 3 pounds, and he's expected adult.
Oh, you want a little baby rub? Yeah.
So younger children, naturally, they love puppies. They want to play with them. They want to, baby them. So they want to kind of carry them, with them all the time. And, not all of them are, let's put it this way, can be very gentle as needed with the dog. So, something that's very small, like Mini-Me over here, might be a bit too small, for very young children. Again, every kid is different, you know. So some children, you know, even at very young age, they're very gentle, they're very, you know, relaxed. And, you know, if they're supervised, then yeah, they can be around, you know, smaller dogs and without the threat of them, you know, hurting the puppy in any way. But, you know, going with something that's a little bit bigger, you know, it's going on a bit of a safer side, you know, knowing that even if, you know, the kid is going to be a little bit more, you know, aggressive or try to kind of, you know, pull his hair, pull his leg, you know, we're not going to, you know, hurt the puppy in any way. Simba's personality is, you know, is very, very easy to deal with, you know. So he's a very outgoing pup. He's, you know, he's not a yapper, you know, like this guy over here. You know, you see, we put him down, he start yapping, he wants more attention, he demands, you know, his attention, which is good for people who can give, you know, have a lot of spare time, you know, they can, you know, be with the puppy more, they can give him the attention that, you know, it needs. So, I mean, he's definitely going to be someone, you know, and he's also in a size that's better for someone who can, you know, who wants to carry the puppy everywhere they go. They want to put in a, you know, a carrier and carry them with. He's in a, definitely a very convenient, you know, travel size. So if you're a person that likes, you know, to travel a lot, you go on a plane, you know, this size is definitely what you're looking for. Minimi here is about 10 and a half weeks old, almost 11 weeks old. So you can see that, you know, clearly the size difference between the two. So age-wise, they're you know, kind of very close in age. This, you know, Minimi is actually a bit older, but you can see that he's substantially, you know, smaller than little Simba over here. So his expected adult size is, you know, around four, maybe 4.5 pounds full grown, which is very, very tiny, very, very light. So people who, like I said, you know, love holding the puppy a lot and love, you know, they want to carry him with them everywhere, it's going to be very convenient to go with something like that. Now, Minimi is a cross between, again, a Maltese and a Yorkie. So, again, we are looking at a hypoallergenic dog, okay, which, you know, does not shed. Even people that suffer from allergies, you gotta be a very rare person to kind of show symptoms to a puppy that is hypoallergenic. So if you are, or you have friends or family members that are, you know, tend to suffer from allergies, you definitely want to, you know, look for a hypoallergenic puppy and kind of, you know, prevent, you know, them from you know, suffering from the puppy. As you can see, I mean, with the Morkies, the Maltese and Yorkie mixes, you know, they, and you know, that goes for most of the designer breeds. So when we deal with, you know, purebred dogs, there is the standard for the breed, and most purebred dogs will look similar to, you know, the breed. So the coloring are specific to the breed. You know, for Yorkies, you know, they're mostly, you know, black and tan, or steel blue and tan, and then they can kind of differ in shades. But you won't see, well, I mean, you know, now they have some like brown Yorkies but you know, they're not very common, you know. So the common, you know, look for the breed is the black and tan, or the steel blue and tan. When we start dealing with designer breeds, so it changes, because some of them will get, you know, the genes from the dad, some will get, you know, the colors from the mom, and since we're mixing two breeds, you know, every litter is like a surprise, you know, you don't really know what you're gonna get. So this little guy, basically coloring wise, he looks like a Yorkie, okay? He looks like a Yorkie. However, if we notice, you know, if we look at his 10 parts, okay, his 10 markings, we can see that, you know, he's very, very light. And if we look, I don't know if you can, you know, show the camera. So if we look at his roots, Okay, we see that that's the color that he's gonna turn eventually. He's gonna be beautiful, you know, very light, you know, it's like grayish, but the official color is it's steel blue. So he's gonna be, he's gonna, you know, lose like the black color that he has like as a puppy. That's only his puppy coat, but eventually he's gonna turn out to be very light colored. And I think personally, you know, I love that look, you know, they look like silver, very fancy. And of course, hair wise, you know, his hair is gonna grow long, and he's gonna have the beautiful Yorkie look if wanted. You know, if not, you know, we can always keep his hair short, with what we call the puppy cut. And of course, it makes it more easy for us, you know, maintaining, cleaning, brushing, and stuff like that. So this is little mini me. We're gonna put him down for a second so we can show, you know, the third puppy that we have here. Let's see if we can stay quiet a little bit so it's not gonna make us too much noise. So the third one that we have over here is this little gorgeous Maltipoo. Okay, Maltipoos. Well, we don't need to introduce them too much because they you know, gain a lot of popularity in the last few years. When I started, you know, breeding dogs, it was, you know, about 13, 14 years ago. Maltipoos were, you know, not very popular. I mean, the whole designer breed saga kind of started, I want to say, you can say good, you know, 7, 8 years ago. Before that, everyone were just kind of looking for you know, purebred dogs. And everyone wanted, you know, purebred dogs. They wanted, you know, they wanted a dog with papers. They wanted to see the pedigree. You see, look how they, look at these guys. I know. He just wants attention. And he's like, stupid. We shall hold, gonna stay quiet. So, as I was saying, you know, if we go back, you know, 10 years ago, we, you know, everyone that called, they want, you know, just looking for the purebred dogs. They either want a Yorkie, they want a Maltese, they want a poodle, they want, you know, a Shih Tzu. They you know, if you just told them, hey, you know what, I have this dog, but it's not registered. Oh, you know, maybe it's mixed with something else. I don't want it. You know, it's and again, I want to say, to my opinion, around 8, 9 years ago, we started to see a change. You know, we started people, you know, calling and asking specifically for mixed breed dogs. You know, they want to have, you know, that what we call the designer dogs, again, because of the advantages they have. One advantage that we already talked about is colors, okay? So poodles come with, you know, a variety of colors, but, you know, some people, for instance, they don't like the very curly hair of the poodle. And when we mix a Maltese with a poodle, I love her personality, for instance, you know, very cuddly, very quiet, very, you see, she was in the background all this time, and, you know, we didn't even know that she is there, you know, we couldn't even notice her because she was, you know, sitting quietly and waiting for her turn. But, you know, when we mix basically a Maltese with a poodle, we get, you know, puppies that are again colorful. So this specific one, you can see she's all white, but, you know, like her face has this beautiful little tannish, creamish, champagne markings in them, and that's something that, you know, you just don't get with a purebred Maltese. Purebred Maltese are always just, you know, snow white. So someone that likes some variety in the coloration would definitely, you know, want to go with something like that. Plus, you know, poodles are very known to be very smart breed of dogs. So As far as training and, you know, again, altogether adapting to the new place has something to do with, the dog's IQ. So some dogs, you know, are known to be very rambunctious, you know, very kind of crazy and hard to train, hard to kind of teach them what's expected from them. And you know, the poodles are very smart, and also the mix itself, you know, the multi-poos are known to be very easy to train, very very well adapting to the new environment. So multi-poos, I mean, today some people, you know, they're will be a lot more interested in multi-poos than either purebred Maltese or purebred poodle. You know, multi-poos gained, like I said, a lot of popularity in the last few years, and now they're actually one of the most desirable, you know, mixed breed of dogs that we carry. Little Pink here is, you know, she's about 9.5 weeks old, and as you can see, she's not a very petite pup, you know. So her expected adult size is somewhere around, you know, 9 or 10 pounds, which again, families that has younger children, families that has you know, other dogs, if it's, you know, a toy breed of dog or even larger breed of dog, as you can see, even these two, Mini-Me and Simba. Simba was trying to play with Mini-Me. Mini-Me is very small, you know, he's not very, you know, interested in playing with someone who's a lot bigger and stronger than him. So, you know, if you have already another dog at home and it's a bit of a, you know, bigger size dog, then going with something like that, you know, it's going to be an excellent idea. So you're going to enjoy a puppy that's relatively small. You can still carry her around, you can still take her in the car, you can still, you know, go places with her, but you know, she's not too fragile where you're gonna, you know, be afraid that, you know, the other dog might hurt her, or if we have, you know, younger kids at home, we're not gonna we don't have to worry about that. And face wise, I think, you know, she's just absolutely stunning. In general, that's, you know, has nothing to do with the designer breed, but you know, that's about as far as, you know, our place. As you can see, all of our puppies are you know, home raised, and you know, we keep them in superior conditions. All of them are up to date on their shots, which is absolutely, you know, required. They've all been dewormed, and all of our puppies have been, you know, vet checked, and make sure that, you know, they're absolutely in perfect conditions, healthy and fit for sale. We invite everyone to, you know, visit our website, which is puppyheaven.com. So you can see, you know, all the rest of the information about these puppies and all the rest of the puppies that we have here. We do carry a variety of breed of dogs. We carry Yorkshire Terriers, we carry Maltese, we carry Shih Tzus, and of course, Pomeranians, and all the beautiful mixes, you know, which are the Molshi, the Maltipoos, the Morkies, Yorkie Poos, Pomshies. We're having a lot of fun with all those, you know, nice designer breeds that we have available. We invite you to go on our website, you know, check out our puppies. If you have questions, you can always call us. Our number here is 818-757-7473, just in case you want to pick up the phone and give us a call and even schedule an appointment to come and visit us and our puppies. That's it for today. We hope you enjoyed and learned a little bit about designer breeds, and we'll see, you know, if we get good feedback, we might do another video on some other breed of dogs and some other puppies. If you like this video, you know, go ahead and subscribe, and you know, we'll be sure that you know, every once in a while we'll update some videos of new available puppies, and we'll make some more fun videos like that. So thank you everyone for watching, and we hope you enjoyed. We'll see you next time.
You already got some questions.
Oh yeah?
People were popping up asking about our phone number and stuff, so you must have missed it. But yeah, right after the pop.
Cool. Oh, I think we're still live.